70 dead, many still unaccounted. Lakhs of lives turned upside down as catastrophic flash floods triggered by heavy rains brought life to a crippling halt in both the Telugu states, in Andhra as well as Telangana. Hello and welcome in this edition of Sensational South. We're going to get you ground reports from Telangana's Khammam to Andhra's Vijayawada, which has never seen a situation like this in the last 5 decades, where more than 40% of the city is underwater. Rescue operation here at Ajit Singh Nagar is at the most affected area right now. This is street number 15 and 16, Totavari Vidhi. In this particular area, the water level is more than 3 feet, and as you walk straight, or the water level keeps rising up to your chest level. In fact, the challenge is, right now we are on a tractor. This tractor cannot go beyond a certain point because the tractor will not work. They're only waiting for boats to come here, and the boats also have been struggling to reach this part. I'm going to speak to one such resident here. In fact, he has come all the way from that part of the colony, street number 15 and 16, to gather some provisions which have come through this. Sir, please tell me, what is the situation there?
Yeah, actually last 2 days we are facing a lot of issues also. Like day before yesterday, almost 12 feet water is happened. Like almost last 2 days, even no one is support anything, either water, either food, everything, no one is support. Like almost like 70 years aged people also is there, and pregnancy people also is there.
How you have been managing so far? How have you been managing?
Like actually all young people, almost like 4 to 5 people is there. Like actually we are, we know that swim, right? That's why like we are support to like our entire apartment.
So have the boats come there yet?
Yeah, actually like only for who are given, I'm talking about high official people is there, like some of the government employees, they're supporting to only for official people. Okay. But no one supporting to as a common man.
So the reach is very less. Boats, yes, have come there, but yes, but very few reach is what you're saying.
Yes.
All,
yes,
right, so I won't take much of your time because you have a long journey ahead. But yes, this is typically the situation. Apart from these tractors which are distributing food and other materials, NDRF teams have deployed these boats, using them to rescue senior citizens, particularly those with medical illnesses, particularly, and even pregnant women, children, a lot of them being moved to safety. These boats are operating in those areas where the water level at this juncture is still about 6 feet. In some parts of Ajit Nagar, where the water flow from the Budumeru River has been heavy. Where are these people being taken? They are being moved to relief camps. Some of them perhaps going to their relatives' house, and or to some of them even booking hotels now to move to some area where they can stay temporarily. They have in fact left their homes primarily because it is completely submerged, and by the time the water retreats, which is expected to happen in the next 24 to 72 hours to some extent, I'm going to speak to a volunteer here who is going to tell us what exactly a day in his life looks like. Got the 4 days nunchi meeru same areas survey chestunnaru, relief material you're distributing. Appudu main challenges as a volunteer, ఏముంది, వాట్ ఆర్ ద ఛాలెంజెస్?
గత 4 రోజులుగా ఏపీఎస్ఎఫ్ఎల్ అండ్ డోర్స్ కార్పొరేషన్ ద్వారా డోన్స్ ద్వారా ఎక్కడైతే లోటత్తు ప్రాంతాల్లో ఉన్నటువంటి ప్రజలకి ఈ ఫుడ్స్ని అలాగే ఎమర్జెన్సీ నీడ్స్ ఉన్న వాటర్స్ని వి హ్యావ్ డిస్ట్రిబ్యూటెడ్ వాటర్స్ అండ్ మెడికల్ ఎమర్జెన్సీ అండ్ ఫుడ్ రూరల్ ఏరియాస్ అండ్ వీఆర్ ఫేసింగ్ నాట్ ఏబుల్ టు మీట్ అవర్ డోన్స్ అండ్ వెహికల్స్ ఎన్డీఆర్ఐ టీమ్స్ అండ్ షుడ్ బి మూవ్ టు దట్ లొకేషన్ అండ్ ఈ డిస్ట్రిబ్యూటెడ్ ఫుడ్స్ అండ్ వాటర్స్
రిలీఫ్ అండ్ రెస్క్యూ ఆపరేషన్ Ajit Singh Nagar, an area that has been completely ravaged by the heavy rains and the flash floods. Drones are being utilized to reach out to homes where accessibility is extremely challenging. This drone that you see right now is carrying a payload of less than 10 kilos, but it is capable of carrying payload up to 10 kilos. It is now headed towards that house where you can see people are waving. There is a drone operator right here where I'm reporting from. That drone operator identifies people using the camera attached to the drone. And look at the way the drone is headed towards that blue building there where families are waiting for provisions to reach them. Now, each of these packets right now at this juncture are carrying water bottles, bananas, biscuit packets, milk packets, and then you can see here instructions are being given to lower the drone. The drone finds a suitable position, lowers itself until the point where the receiver is able to get his hands on that packet. Now, in this particular area, Singh Nagar colony, as we speak, the government, state government, is operating close to 35 drones. We are at the Ajit Singh Nagar, and this is one of the worst hit areas, perhaps the most crippled area because of the floods here. And what you're seeing right now is slight improvement, in the sense that a lot of people have been finally able to step out of their house. Majority of them are either going to their relative's house, friend's house, or and the other half is perhaps going over to the other side, AV Nagar here and other parts of the city, to collect some provisions. In fact, I'm being joined by one such family, friends, who are also making their way to the other side, but they have to almost walk a stretch up to 2 kilometers to cross this bridge and get their provisions. I want to start with you. What is the situation, little bit about yourself as well?
Yes, this started in Sunday, approximately in the morning. There were no intimation given for us that floods are going to take place and water is being filled and all that. We were not being told and we were not being intimated. For past 2 days, we did not have proper supplies. I thank the street members. They were like going out, getting provisions for us, getting water, at least water we needed. Drinking water we needed. They used to go and come. Only the people who are living beside of us, they are the ones who got us supplies. Others would others like who are supposed to help us, no one came near us to help us also.
Sir, thank you so much for your time. I want to understand, looking at the scale of devastation, you just said this is the biggest disaster that you've seen. What kind of help are you going to reach out for center?
Now, first of all, they have to declare national disaster. There are some guidelines. On the basis of that, government of India has to study and give for rebuilding who are all lost because of this disaster. That is what we are going to present. One side, agriculture crops, huge loss. Second side, some assets we have lost. Third one, this Vijayawada city is totally lost because of all these things. All these things will project for national calamity fund.
Will you be seeking a national calamity status also for this entire disaster?
No, we request government of India. They are having some guidelines, all these things, but it is our duty to present before them.
Sir, you have turned Vijayawada Collectorate into your home come office also. I want to understand, you've been relentlessly going around. What is the scale of devastation right now, and how long is it going to take for entire normalcy to return?
Now, for the last 2 days, around 4 to 5 lakh people don't have power. And also, they don't have water, they don't have food, they are suffering, they cannot move freely because of water. Some people are suffering because of moving in that. Even without having water, they are there for the last 2 days. This is the biggest suffering. But government is doing its best to meet their requirements. We are able to mobilize any amount of water. But problem is to reach the last mile people. That is the biggest challenge.
And approximately how long is it going to take for the situation?
Tomorrow, today, more or less, we are able to reach 60-70%. Tomorrow, we will reach 100%. And then I want to go for saturation.
My last question, sir, very quickly. Why is our CP has accused you of not taking enough preparedness? How do you respond to that?
I am asking you, what is preparedness? I am here only.
I am coming to you from Bhavanipuram Housing Board Colony. This is what the situation is right now. Water completely inundating the entire street, which has about 500 houses by rough estimate. Though the water level has gone down, it was up to almost 3 feet on Saturday, Sunday during the torrential rainfall. Though the water level has receded, but life has certainly come to a standstill. And there you can see the way people are struggling. You can see a woman there collecting her supplies and provision that has been just provided by the volunteers of the state government, and now making her way to her house. She says that while everything is being given to them, it is only the lack of clean water for utility purpose. They have drinking water, they have milk to consume, they have food which is being given, but the lack of water for utility purpose, that is making a little bit of challenge here for them. And in fact, take a look at this entire colony. The water came up to the first floor in many houses, and this is a low-lying area. The Budumeru rivulet is just a few colonies away, and the water from there. But this is the first time that the rivulet has thrown up, and for the first time in I think almost 20 years, this entire area has been inundated like this. Other thing that I want to highlight from the ground is the role of civic volunteers. Here you can see they're distributing food here, upma, water being given, and a lot of people are coming and taking their supplies and trying to wade through that water and go over to the other side. I just want to have a word. Sir, what is the situation right now here?
Right now, no current, madam. People are coming down and shifting from their houses.
They're moving away.
They're moving to their neighbor houses, relatives, neighbors, like that. Because only they are providing on the main road only. Government is providing facilities on the main road, like food and something like milk and medicines. Inner side, in small streets, they are not
able to reach
and they are not going also. Because in this area, they have minimum 5,000 houses above. So to reach them, they do not have sufficient
resources.
And
so, is the food being distributed through boats or drones? What is being used? Or tractors?
Tractors and by these boats.
Okay.
Yes, they have distributed like that. Today they are coming like the Tata AC. There you can see, no?
What is being given in the government packets? What are they providing?
Upma they are providing. Pulihara, veg biryani, and milk like that, something, water facilities.
Have you seen this kind of situation ever since?
No, madam, no. 30 years too, I did not see. Before 30 also, I remember, I did not see like this situation. Okay.
scale of damage is definitely staggering. And you know, there you can see the way people are carrying food packets one by one. And this is not just one trip, they have to make several trips, especially those who are living at the frontal part, to come over to this side, take the food, go back. And on the other end, there are some government resources there who have been distributing food. But yes, Chief Minister Chandrababu Naidu has also said that they've been targeting last mile reach, and that is a big challenge at this point in time. Though Chief Minister has been relentlessly touring different parts of the city, but last mile connectivity is one big challenge. They say 70% of it is done, and the remaining they will be able to achieve a 100% target only when rest of the resources come in terms of NDRF, SDRF, local volunteers, all the hands on the deck. And that is certainly happening on the ground, but given this unprecedented situation, it may take a longer period of time. We're bringing you our dispatch from Khammam. Khammam is the worst affected district in Telangana. What you see behind me is the Muneru River, that is the tributary of the Krishna River. It's in spate. In fact, the situation right now at this point in time is much better. Yesterday, when the rains wreaked havoc and there was a flash flood-like situation in Khammam, the water level was almost up till the bridge. Right now, it continues to remain in full swing, swirling waters there, but still, locals say situation is slightly better. Better in terms of the river, but if you look at the entire infrastructure, that has in fact taken a hard blow. Right now, Venkatesh, my video journalist, will show you, there is a JCB which is working to build the road. Now, on to the left-hand side is the road that leads to Khammam. And the particular area where we're standing right now is little outskirts of Khammam. It's surrounding the urban area, and now the route has been completely damaged because of the floods. Yesterday it was completely cut off. This morning, when the rains finally stopped, a JCB came into the picture, and now it is doing the patchwork, which is very much necessary. Okay, what he's saying is that the colony behind us, adjoining the Muneru River, was completely inundated. In fact, the situation was very bad. People there have been moved away.
Abhi idhar hua so kal ka hua tha, magar koi department wala idhar koi respond nahi hua. Jo pani jo zyada aa gaya wo ye hamara godam mein. Hum log idhar kaam karte wo aage tak pani aa gaya. Magar hum log kisi ko bhi phone kiya to abhi koi aako कोई रेस्पॉन्ड भी नहीं हुआ. रात 11 बजे तक 12 बजे तक पानी के पीने के पानी की भी नहीं है, खाने का खाना भी नहीं है. कोई नहीं आया, कोई क्या हुआ बोल को देखने को भी नहीं आया.
कौन किधर रहते हैं, कौन से कॉलोनी में रहते हैं?
यही हमारा घर है.
अच्छा, आगे एकदम
फ्लड आ गया. हाँ. फ्लड आने के बाद क्या हुआ, पूरा पानी अंदर आ गया. हाँ. हम लोग उधर से ऊपर गया, ऊपर से ऊपर चले गया, ऊपर से ऊपर ऐसा हमारा उधर रहता था, ऊपर से फ्लड आ गया, ऊपर से थोड़ा ऊपर ऊपर से ऊपर चले गया. हम लोग पूछ रहे कोई किसको भी तो भी फोन किया तो हमारे को मालूम नहीं किसको बोलता है कि बोल लो, यही बोल दिया. मगर कुछ भी नहीं, कोई सा भी डिपार्टमेंट वाला भी रेस्पॉन्ड नहीं हुआ.
कहाँ तक आया था पानी?
पानी आ गया, पूरा पानी आया से पानी से ही चले गए, पूरा रोड चला गया. मगर नुकसान हो गया, ऊपर से नुकसान बहुत हो गया. कितना लोग मर गया, कितना क्या हुआ, फिर क्या कैसा है बोल को भी कोई डिपार्टमेंट वाला भी नहीं आया. क्या हुआ बोल के पूछने की भी कोई नहीं है इधर, ऐसा आ गया इधर.
People are angry because of the situation yesterday, where the entire area got inundated, flooded rather. They did not find help, but help has reached them in the form of this JCB right now, which is fixing the roads. And perhaps there is expectation that the rest of the things in terms of power, food and other medicinal facilities that they're looking for will also be expected. They're also expecting that their local MLA visit them here. And in fact, in that context, Chief Minister Revanth Reddy himself is slated to visit Khammam because this is the worst hit area. It has been a dreadful sleepless night for the residents of Motinagar. This is in Khammam, not too far away from River Muneru, which in fact in full spate yesterday swept away the entire colony. And what remains is this. You can see there's a lot of mud that's left behind, and whatever were their life savings now stand completely destroyed. Chairs, gas stove, in fact tea, fridge, television. कल पानी कहाँ तक आया था?
अरे मैडम इतने दूर आया मैडम, ये लखी रहे ना पानी, ये पानी है मैडम, उतना दूर आ गया मैडम. सब खराब हो गया मैडम, टीवी खराब हो गया, गैस सब फ्रिज सब खराब हो गया मैडम. तो रोना एक ही है,
कोई भी है मिनिस्टर, तीन मिनिस्टर है, कोई भी नहीं आया अब तक। हमने देखने भी कोने कहा पानी दिया ना, ना खाना नहीं दिया।
मुझे बताइए कल रात या फिर कल शाम से जब पूरा बारिश हो रहा था, कितने बजे से पानी आने लगा, फिर आप लोगों का परिस्थिति क्या था?
नौ बजे से रात तमाम पानी है। सुबह सुबह 6 बजे टाइम पर कम दी होने से हम अंदर का आया, पानी निकल गया, हम घर में गया मैडम।
आपको हेल्प आया है कहीं से?
कोई भी नहीं आना है, हेल्प कोई भी करना नहीं मैडम, हेल्प कोई भी कौन नहीं करे। दा पानी नहीं दिया, थोड़ा खाना भी नहीं दिया, कैसा है बेचारा को देखने वाला भी कोई भी नहीं है मैडम। ये तो तीन मिनिस्टर है, तीन मिनिस्टर में पुलिस वाला नहीं आया, कलेक्टर नहीं आया, काउंसलर नहीं आया, कौन भी नहीं आया।
8 बजे कल से पानी, घर पूरा बर्बाद हो गया, फ्रिज टीवी सभी आगम हो गया, खाने का चावल गया, खाने का क्या भी नहीं है, एक दाना भी सभी घर पूरा बर्बाद।
में कभी इतना बारिश हुआ है?
कभी नहीं हुआ मेरा, इससे पहले एक बार आज सदर ले दे, बार सामान पूरा देता हो गया।
क्या करते हो?
तरकारी बेचते मैडम हमें रोड पे,
सब्जी बेचते हैं मैडम।
We are vendors basically, and in fact ये आपका खुद का घर है?
नहीं मैडम, किराए का।
किराए घर है मैडम हमारे, क्या मेहनत कर ली तो निकलता मैडम, मेहनत नहीं करी तो पैसा नहीं, क्या भी नहीं, आज जाएंगे तो भूखे पैसे मर जाना हमें लोग।
ఇప్పుడు ఇల్లు కడుకుందామన్నా కూడా వాటర్ కూడా లేదు, ఆ వాటర్ ఫెసిలిటీస్ కూడా ఏది లేదు, కనీసం తాగటానికి కూడా వాటర్ లేదు.
Okay, I'll just quickly translate what he's saying. In fact, అన్న మీ ఇల్లు ఎక్కడ ఉంది? ఇదే. Okay. He stays here and he's saying that the water came up till the level of the gate, and when the water started increasing, they moved all their kids upstairs, but such was the situation that they saw a lot of insects. In fact, a lot of the kids were also bitten by cockroaches, he mentions. And he's dialed the number 100 police multiple times, but he got no response. So left with no choice, they all, in fact not just him, almost everyone in this colony started assembling at buildings wherever there are some terrace or up to first floor or second floor, just to move themselves to safety while they still expected help to come in certain ways.
Joining us is director and the man of the moment, Venkat Prabhu sir. Thank you so much for talking to us.
Thank you.
Your press conference was a mega hit. Was that itself was like a promotion for the movie? Are you nervous, excited? Because it's a Vijay film and there are a lot of...
For every film, the excitement, the thrill, the tension is always there. But this time, it's probably 100 times more than before, I think. Because... It has become most expected film of the year, and it's Vijay sir's film, and so it's been like nearly 2 months since I've properly slept as well, you know. So very thrilled, very tensed, very excited, very emotional, and all sorts of feelings is going through my whole body now.
Every film of yours is full of suspense and surprises. Is this movie similar, or have you sort of made changes considering it's actor Vijay's film?
No, it's very similar. I want to excite the audience. I want to surprise them. I want to I want to make them sit in the edge of the seat, and I want them to emote to what my actors are feeling, and I want them to laugh out loud, and I want to give them all sorts of a wholesome entertainment was the idea. And a person like Vijay sir, you know, doing a film with, I want it to be a celebration for him, because it's nearly his second last film, and I wanted this to be like a farewell kind of a thing where we can celebrate him.
So you are someone who will write scripts thinking of actors in mind. For this movie, was it any different? Because you've never had a mismatch in your films ever.
No, this first. When I started, during COVID, I think, I started, I got this idea and I was developing it. But that time, I thought of, you know, doing it with an older actor and a younger actor. That's how I started writing the thing. Then when I came to know about this technology of de-aging, and there was this movie called Gemini Man where they de-aged and digitally created Will Smith as a 20-year-old. and there's a 50-year-old in the film and stuff like that. So I thought, why don't we do something like that and excite? Vijay sir was like, no, don't do so much of physical changes, man. It's I think they're used to my face, and just make it a little comfortable for them as well, so they can easily connect. So we went and redid the whole thing and made some corrections. So now in the trailer, what you saw in the trailer is what you're going to see in the film.
Talking about Vijay, this was supposed to be his last film, and now he's doing one more film. Because considering that this could have been his last film, did he want to do certain scenes, or because it's going to be a tribute to him as an actor, did he want specific scenes
Nothing. He will never want to do something like that. You know, if he agrees to a script, if he believes and he agrees to the script, there's no changes at all in the script. It was just a narration. But I took a long time for this narration. He will never say. He will probably try to enhance the scene. He will not try to change the scene. There is nothing political in the film. It's not a political film. It is not about. It's a pure cinema. It's just a pure commercial where. இப்போ நம்ம சில்லறை எல்லாம் செதற விட்டு விசையில் அந்த மாதிரியான ஒரு 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 ஃபிலிம். ஐ வாண்ட் யூ கைஸ் டு கம் இன் அண்ட் ஜஸ்ட் ஹாவ் ஃபன் அண்ட் ஹாவ் என்ஜாய் த தியேட்டர் மூமெண்ட்ஸ் அண்ட் லீவ் வித் லாட் ஆஃப் யூனோ குட் தட் ஜஸ்ட் ஹேவிங் அ குட் டைம்.